Whether it's on the battlefield or at the site of a disaster, the iconic Humvee has served the United States loyally since 1985, and over those 30 years more than 281,000 Humvees have rolled off the AM general production lines. U.S. Department of Defense initiated Joint Light Tactical Vehicle, JLTV, program to replace and improve upon the aging Humvee. A rigorous testing exercise was undertaken to choose a model from three different vendors. Oshkosh was declared as winner on August 25, 2015, when its model was selected over Lockheed Martin and AM General's models. JLTV is as much as a technology leap over the Humvee, as the Humvee was to the Jeep-like Ford M151 MUTT before it. Although Humvees will continue to serve behind the scenes with the Army and Marines until 2050, the new JLTV will be in the front line. Overall, JLTV requirements are 5,500 vehicles for the Marine Corps entering service in FY 2020 with all to be delivered in FY 2022, and 49,099 for the Army entering service in late 2019 with deliveries occurring through 2040. In this video, Defense Updates lists top 5 improvements that Oshkosh JLTV has over the Humvee. Number 5. While the Humvee continues to prove itself as a versatile military design, the Iraq and Afghanistan conflicts revealed a fatal flaw: insufficient protection from improvised explosive devices, IDE. The Oshkosh JLTV chassis has been designed to provide better survivability. Compared to an up-armored Humvee, a basic Oshkosh JLTV offers multiple orders of magnitude more protection from bullets and bombs to its occupants. Also, each Oshkosh JLTV is capable of being fitted with a B kit of armor, boosting protection to levels similar to that of mine-resistant ambush-protected (MRAP) vehicles. It is a very important thing. Pentagon findings showed that in 2009, U.S. troops in MRAPs were 17 times more likely to survive IED blasts than in Humvees. Number 4. Since the Humvee first went into service, its engine has been upgraded to a 6.5-liter turbo diesel V8 that produces an inadequate 190 horsepower and 780 pounds-to-foot of torque. That's hardly enough power to motivate the base Humvee's roughly 6,000-pound curb weight, let alone a 13,000-plus-pound curb weight of an armored Humvee. The end result is Humvees have a top speed of 70 miles per hour. The Oshkosh JLTV uses tweaked General Motors Duramax 6.6-liter turbo diesel V8. The current variant of the engine summons 397 horsepower and 765 pounds-to-foot of torque. This power will be able to propel the vehicle to a top speed of 100 miles per hour. Double the torque will also enable the JLTV to better navigate tricky terrain. Number 3. Although Humvees were initially pretty reliable in the field, as they aged and as the military upgraded them with heavy armor that increased wear and tear, they needed more and more maintenance. During the testing phase of the JLTV program, the U.S. Army and Marine Corps brought along 22 up-armored Humvees to test alongside Oshkosh, Lockheed Martin, and AM General's JLTV entrants, with each manufacturer providing 22 test vehicles. During nearly 3 years of testing, platoons equipped with Oshkosh JLTVs had the highest levels of mission success. Oshkosh's JLTVs were also far and away the most reliable of the bunch, averaging 7,051 miles between operational mission failures, defined as a system failure that prevents the vehicle from accomplishing its mission. Up-armored Humvees were surprisingly the second most reliable of the group, averaging 2,968 miles between failures, followed by the Lockheed Martin JLTV at 1,271 miles between failures, and the AM General JLTV, which averaged only 526 miles between failures. Number 2. Oshkosh fits each JLTV with its TAC4i suspension system. It is fully independent double wishbone design with electronically adjustable high-pressure gas shocks. The JLTV's suspension has 20 inches of wheel travel, and the ability to raise and lower the suspension as needed. It is significantly better than Humvee's ground clearance of 16 inches. In a Humvee, the troops tend to be thrown around inside the cabin when the Humvee travels over rough terrain. 2 to 3 hours of such travel can leave the occupant significantly fatigued. The advanced suspension in JLTV provides a much smoother rides, as the cabin practically floats over the wheels. The wheels move up and down a lot, but the cabin remains stable. Number 1. The Humvee was never designed to tightly integrate with multiple sensors or process a lot of information. The Oshkosh JLTV is designed from ground up to incorporate multiple sensors and informational systems. This includes the following. 1. Long-range surveillance, enabling early detection of threat. 2. Shot detection, easily find origin of incoming fire. 3. Silent watch power systems, low noise mode, harder to detect. 4. Visible light and IR camera systems, better visual recognition. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.